Hello, my name is Mordred Viking, and I'd like to welcome you to episode 47 of this Let's Play Europa Universalis IV. This is the March of the Vikings, and we are Mordgard. In the last episode, we concluded the war against Hawaii and gave a whole bunch of territory to you. We expanded the number of territories we had, which was actually, with hindsight, a mistake. At least at the point we did it, because it has increased the price of embracing, because the embracing of technology is only for your states, not your territories. So the price has gone up from 5,800 to 7,000 again, but we are still waiting for India to finish embracing, and that's not too far off. I mean, most of these are in their 80s and their 90s now, which is awesome. Meanwhile, areas over here are getting it very slowly, so we're not going to wait for those. Because there's a couple over there with... Oh, wow. These have got it already. I wonder how they got it so quick. I mean, awesome, but... Wow. Okay. No, we're still just waiting for these. Won't take too much longer. Nationalism against Andalusian La Plata... Let's actually have a look elsewhere around the world. So Norway has completely dominated in Scandinavia. Nordriki taking a good chunk. Lithuania and Poland having pushed straight across. Byzantium not having shifted very much. Farhands taking way more territory over here. They were actually the ones that killed the Joms Vikings, I think. Noble families feud. We'll actually take the uprising. Because, honestly, you're not going to be the best. We'll just go and kill you. Marvellous. And also, please do continue converting. That would be great. So, the other thing is they are still unhappy, so be it. We do need to think about who to attack next. Missionaries are all doing their job. You guys are doing all yours. Right, did Ajuran take out the Joms Vikings? They did. So, that should mean that we can now release them as a vassal. If and when I remember how the hell you do that. I don't remember. Would have thought it would be in here. There we go. Oh, I still can't do it. Why not? Do the Joms Vikings still exist somewhere? They must... Oh, it's probably Cyprus. Yeah. Can I offer you vassalization? No. You hate us. Can I just declare war on you? I mean, we have the Imperialism CB, which would allow me to do so. I'd still need to sail all the way around here, which costs rather a lot in naval attrition. Unless we've got the naval attrition thing, which is at what level? I can't remember. I have a feeling we have it already. There is basically one diplomatic technology which reduces or basically removes naval attrition. I just don't remember when. I have a feeling it's already. Actually, there is a way of finding out. Let's grab you and just sail out to the middle of the Pacific and basically watch how much attrition you take. If it stays at 1%, then we're fine. If it goes to like 20%, then we can't do it. Yet. 6%. Open sea. Nope, you're open again. We won the Battle of Kutch, as I thought we would. You still hates us in terms of liberty desire, but that can be reduced through prestige payments. In fact, we should probably do that. Placate local rulers. Placate. Oh, we can't do it anymore. Oh, it's 20 prestige per 10. I thought it was less. What are you on? 6%. Just stay where you are. Still on 6%. See, it usually rises over time. Then yes, you are... We do have the attrition reducing thing. Which means that we could go after the Joms Vikings. Realistically. So what we're going to do is we're going to sail over to India. We're going to pick up these two units here, and we're going to go after the Oms Vikings. And we'll just use the Imperialism CB when we're basically next to them. Marvellous! Oh, we could also finish offensive ideas, which would allow us to have more discipline, which would be nice. Although we're not that far off getting the next technology. Nope, we'll wait. I'm kind of surprised that you hasn't had any rebels. How are you doing with the conversions? You're building some more ships. You have a bit of conversion done. And by a bit, I mean two provinces. Hey, it's a start. It's fine. It counts. Alright, institutions. How are we doing? There we go. 99. Yeah, just these guys are in the 90s. We'll wait for them. Probably won't bother waiting for you or you. We'll just get these. And then after that, we should be able to afford the institution for, yeah, not too much. Cool. It was just my mistake in having spread so many territories over into, like, Indonesia and elsewhere. Unfortunately, there it will spread slowly. Another conversion. What's going on here? Oh, it's just more rebels. No surprise there, then. Oh, right. Mombasa's there. I was thinking it was in India for some reason. That was Mumbai. Never mind. Right. Are we done yet? We are done. Except for Poon, which is... Oh yeah, these two are still close. You're 91, which is... Yeah. You're 93. You know, we can wait. It's fine. Bharat started to get it. Is there anyone that's, like, more than... Oh, yeah. Kazumbe has not even got feudalism yet. It has global trade, though, apparently. It has global trade. Shoshone have got feudalism, renaissance, colonialism. I love the fact they have global trade and nothing else. Not even feudalism. Yeah, most of you have most things. Bilge is still alive. They don't even have the printing press yet, but they're alive. Are you still a step horde? You are a step horde. Wow, you've survived a hell of a long time. I'm actually legitimately impressed by that. Well done. Alright, I was going to have a look elsewhere. So actually, Australasia seems to have conquered a bit more of Britain. Andalusia, Aquitaine, still alive, kind of clinging on. Navarre's company has done well. They've definitely expanded. Italy, obviously. Denmark's lost quite a lot to Italy, I would say. Who are you fighting? Ooh, Italy's fighting Poland. Nice. Nordriki's consolidated. Oh, Poland's gone up there as well. That's unfortunate. And there's a big influence reduction thing, which is good. I'll lose the money. Right, now we should definitely have the institutions here. Oh, you know what? 96 and 98%, we may as well wait for them. They're not far off. Rigorous researchers. Academic institutions are not immune to corruption, and the profits that can be made by abusing positions of great influence can stand in the way of creating a good environment for learning. Two of a kind. Our Empress Consort, Xiao Lu, has impressed many men and women at court with her sharp wit and extensive knowledge of the natural world. No, I'm not getting rid of the Inquisitor, because he's kind of integral to my mass conversion plans. Brunei. We do have an army here. Good. Let's go and send Klaus Elisabeth again. Not quite as good as Maud Saga, but it's fine. Yeah, you're crushing them. Ciao, ciao. Oops. Go and kill them. Yeah, you got that. Chow Chow was one. That's victory. Good, good. And institutions. How are we looking? Just you, and you're probably a 99. Oh, no, 98. And how fast do you spread? Canton, I'll deal with you in a minute. 0.62. An attack into you. Border friction. I'll release their liking of us. Nation and Namalland, faithful allies, requesting we come to the aid of the second Namalland crusade against Kosala again. Alright, in that case, we are going to, at this point, embrace the institution for 4,300. That sounds a lot better. Ooh, embracement cost's gone down. Because we're a great power, we get an embracement cost reduction. I don't remember seeing that before. Interesting. Okay, so we now get the culture conversion cost reduction. We can get the extra discipline, which I would like to have, although we should have got this. That was a mistake. We'll grab you. We'll grab you. We can now get the three deckers, which means we can build the new navy. Heavies. Save. We're going to go heavies. We're just going to go cost us a grand. Acceptable. So we're sending you up there. Namalland, how are you going to do against Kosala? Probably okay. The other thing I want to do is culture conversion is now only 90. We have the Enlightenment. We're the adventuring Vikings. We're fully religious. That's minus 70%. We can actually get another 15%, so we could get up to 85%, but honestly, this is acceptable. So we're going to convert Surat, and then once we have Surat, you can actually get even further cost reduction, because you'll notice culture adjacent to North Konkan, minus 25%. So for you, it is actually 95%. So we could get 110% reduction with the other one. So, I have a feeling it's time for the mass conversions. I'm actually kind of surprised you got the primary culture in Mordgard. Culture adjacent to North Konkan, that is a reduction. Oh, you already are North. Ah, that's why. You are not. Yeah, now it's definitely worthwhile. So we're going to do it. It will cost us a lot, but you know, role-playing and all that, we are Norse. We are now making everyone Norse. We're having the Norse Renaissance right now in India. That's what's going on. Okay, so yes, I will join your war. Who are we actually going to be fighting? That is a good question. Quite a lot of stuff. wow, Namalland, you do know how to pick those fights, don't you? Jeez. All right, we'll send our four units up here. Kind of try and keep you spread out a little bit. And coalitions forming against us in large numbers. I'm only defending my sodding allies here. Jeez. This is me being, like, appropriate. Diplomatic is the military idea. Nope, can't get one. So I think that we're going to go with the level 3. I think that sounds good. Right, you may as well get the really good general and actually go off to Kutch, because they have no other troops over there, although you are coming to reinforce. Wait, is Barat in this war? Oh, you are allied with Barat, you genius! Okay, we've won. We've definitely won. GG. So how's you feeling? Like, are you actually going to be joining this fight? No. I keep on having to placate rulers, and it's getting more and more expensive. Now, we have 61% from the placated rulers, and they have plus 52% from their high development. It'll reduce, it'll be fine. Okay, so you are piling in with troops up here. That'll do. You're leaving Kutch. You've seen what's coming for you. Probably wise, probably wise. In that case, let's bring you guys up here. See if we can cut you off. Where'd you go? Alright, we'll just start conquering you then. There you are. Hello! Right, do we still have claims on this stuff? No. 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 Well, that was a mistake. I still want everything up to Bangladesh, though. So anything north of here, I'm going to give to Namalland to take, but anything south, I'm going to keep it for myself. It's like you, you can go to Namalland. That's totally fine. Let's make sure we have our leaders here. Let's give that guy to you. Let's give you to Namalland. Should have had a commander there. Oh well. Need a new debate in Parliament. Okay, so this is the trade efficiency. I just want to see if it's still around. Entrepreneurs, Burkers, Gotland. No, it's not. Okay, so it has actually run its course. So, the next trade debate is... Oh no, and now there's no culture. Of course not. So we could get the more merchants, the trade company. Get the army and navy tradition decay, which would be quite good. It would allow us to build those up for 10 years. More trade efficiency. More trade power. Don't really need it. Advisor costs. We already get them cheap. Honestly, money is not our... Well, geez. Yeah, money is not our problem right now. I would say let's go and extend the officer commissions. All right, what's this going to cost me? All right, bribing MPs? I am happy to do, because we can afford it. And how is this not increasing the corruption costs? We're not going to do that. We're not going to do that. We're not. We could do the corruption, actually. That's just a small cost. Not going to do this. Definitely not doing that. I kind of like the fact our legitimacy is going up. We're definitely not increasing mercantilism. How exactly meritocracy and mercantilism are interrelated, I'm not sure. Ignore you. What are we up to? 42. Like the cheap military supports we can do. I don't mind doing that. Yeah, I'm in support likewise. Alright, fine. We'll have a look for the 12s. 28, too expensive. 28, too expensive. Crown lands, legitimacy, yeah, fine. Oh man, this is getting expensive. 16 military support, alright, fine. No. Do the commissions. We're not doing meritocracy. That's horrifically expensive. We'll do the Navy commission. We could do some autonomy. It will just tick down over time. You know what? We will. And there we go. Done. Huzzah! Because like, we're so wealthy anyway, it doesn't matter if some of our provinces have more autonomy. Oh, big fight going on. Stay where you are. We can always shift you away. In fact, I would like to do that. Oh, crap. Don't tell me you can't get away. Okay, you did get that. Good. Just double you up. We are now... Oh, no, that still counts as an attack. This is into farmland, so it's not going to be too much of a penalty against us. Come at me, bro. It's fine. Especially as this fort's about to fall. Take a thatter. Good. Come on then. I mean, the longer you're just allowing me to recover manpower and morale if, by not attacking me. We still don't have the next admin tech, though. That's only a production efficiency bonus level. It's not the most important. The one I really need is military, actually. I don't like that we're behind. Let's give you to Namalland. Alright, you are going to Sirbad. What's train here? Hills. Hills. We're going to wait until we come down to one of these two, and then we're going to... Oh, you're actually attacking into Sirbad, which is farmland. Easy! Let's do it. Especially as you're attacking me. Huzzah! Alright, we have a massive morale bonus. Or advantage, rather. Same discipline. And we are Western Tech, so we are kicking your ass. Thank you, Western Tech Pips. You're amazing. Now, this is my fault. Alright, we're taking this stuff nicely. Now the reinforcements are coming. Generals are apparently of the same skill level. That was a conversion, so let's do the next. We're at 86% national unity. Get in! And how's our national unrest? We're at minus 3%, 3 points now, thanks to the lack of overextension. Marvellous. We should be winning this fight. Yeah, they have artillery in the front row. We lost 13,000, they lost 15,000, maybe 16,000. Little one-man unit coming in to die. Shame for you. Alright, let's go and take those. How are we doing elsewhere? Oh, Barat are kicking their ass, which is good. Kamarup has not really happened. Nothing really happened over in China either. And we have 132,000 manpower just waiting to join. Speaking of that, we can now get counting houses, right? Yes, we can. The other question is, do we want to? Well, apparently some of these are worth a lot of money. So, yeah, we do. Especially as we have many factories in many of these places. Like, counting houses just compounds the amount of money that the manufacturers make for us. So we basically just want them everywhere, honestly. Let's do that. Let's just build them everywhere. This is going to make us a silly amount of money. But I'm in a silly mood, so let's do it. Alright, the whole of India has counting houses now, or at least everywhere that can get them. Awesome. Diplomatic approach of the Empress Consort. While growing up in Yu, Xiao Liu enjoyed learning of the world. She was always asking questions and offered pondered ways to make life easier for people, or how to make a given task more effective. Gain diplo power. Awesome. Thank you. We'll give you to Namalland. There we go. So how much has Namalland actually done in this war? 6%. Awesome. I mean, I fought a couple of big battles, but that's nothing compared to what Barat's had to do. This is so one-sided, it's not even funny. Well played, Namalland. Well played. Right, who else are we fighting here? Yeah, we are fighting all of this. This would be a chance of seizing more of Indus. I kind of want to focus more on China, though. Yeah, we'll stay focused on China, it's fine. In the meantime, we can also invest a bit more in culture. 1741. Jeez, that takes a long time. It's kind of a good thing I started when I did. We can't afford. Oh, it's because we're building other stuff or doing something. I don't know. Cool. Onwards. Alright, you two are done over here. Let's start taking some of these forts then, shall we? The army is the way to glory. Our focus on land has left many feeling that we have an excellent army. Some of our brightest and best wish to join officers in it. That is entirely reasonable. Accumulate money. I can do that. Right, so we can get some more policies now that we've completed all of them. I want the horse artillery for the artillery bonus. That is a very strong one. Is there anything else? Missionary strength's not bad. No, I think we're good. That'll do fine. What would be nice to know is whether we can get any more, like, culture cost reducing. Sure, there are some. Max promoted cultures, that's not what I'm after. In fact, does one of these do culture reduction? No. I'm somewhat tempted to do innovative. I wonder if influence does culture. No. Maritime's a good one. Quality would be a good one. Actually, quality would be a really good one. Seeing as we do use navies and armies now. Espionage wouldn't be bad. Innovative wouldn't be bad. And quality tends to have really good policies too. Quality plus religious, morale and siege ability. Economic, more discipline. Trade, more trade efficiency. Innovative is another one that usually has really good policies. Fort maintenance, garrison side, yeah. Trade efficiency, interest, yeah. Maintenance, fort defense. Leader siege, leader siege ability. That would be a nice one, actually. That would be a really nice one to have. Administrative. Income from vassals, rubbish. Trade efficiency, okay. Land attrition, morale recovery, unrest, separatism, shock. Idea cost institution spread. A bit late for that now. Espionage. Fort defense, yearly corruption. Available mercenaries, mercenary maintenance. Rebel support. Ooh, wow. Espionage and economic would mean rebel support efficiency is plus 100%. Interesting. And actually, it's interesting to note in the upcoming patch there, or the patch that should already be out by now. Yeah, that comes out today. The mercenaries, I think, are going to be increased in price. So getting the ideas which reduce mercenary maintenance and cost is a very good idea. That's apparently one of the things that's coming in. I'll probably actually be able to confirm that soon, but I don't have it just yet. Right, I want to give you to Namalland, please. Come on. There we are. There you go. We'll go and attack you with that guy. Mordgard's got Kalat. Good, good, good. Let's continue just taking random forts, because we can just take the stuff around them afterwards. Victory is ours. And with that, in fact, I'm going to say thank you very much for watching. If you are enjoying this series, please do hit that like button. If you haven't done so already, then do consider subscribing. If you have any tips or advice for me, let me know in the comments. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll catch you next time. Goodbye.